No, no, no. Are you kidding me?
That's awesome.
No, that's dumb. No one's gonna take us seriously.
Who wants to be taken seriously? We gotta entertain people. This is a college show.
No, we need to do a show that matters to people.
You're fired.
What? You can't fire me. You're fired.
So what kind of show are we making? Like a mix between them?
I have an idea.
Well what?
IPFW.
Travis Bartlett.
Welcoming you to the very first episode of M.E.H., your Mastodon Entertainment Hub, your go-to resource for on and off-campus news, events, and entertainment. So what's M.E.H., you ask? Well, Travis?
Yes, Kylie?
Someone asked, what is M.E.H.?
Well, it's a sound you make when you're generally apathetic towards a certain person, situation, or statement, obviously.
So if I say, these apple fritters are positively mediocre, you would probably say...
Meh.
Got it. But in our case, it's some sort of satirical ploy, right? Notice an on-campus attitude towards the school and exaggerate it in order to shed some sort of critical light?
Sure.
Meh.
Anyways, welcome to Meh, a hybrid of everything that catches your general interest and then some. This is the first show of its kind at IPFW, and as such, we decided to incorporate a plethora of segments in order to pique every corner of you, the viewer's interest. Think of it as CBS, but with balls and little to lose.
Graphic. And now to start us off, we'll take you to our out-of-studio reporter, Maddie Shine.
Reporting on what exactly?
Texting.
Oh, good. Exactly the kind of thing we didn't want to do, boring the whole four people watching. Great.
Thanks, Travis. Maddie.
In 2012, statistics show that 28% of fatal car accidents are caused by texting and driving. On campus at IPFW today, Society for Human Resource Management gave a demonstration of how dangerous it is to text and drive.
In the state of Indiana, texting and driving is illegal, and for many people, the law enforcement is not always enough. Text messaging makes a crash 23 times more likely to happen, and the unfortunate event of a fatal car accident could have been prevented by simply waiting to respond to a message.
Like any other distraction, eating, putting on makeup, paying too much attention to your radio, any distracted driving is dangerous.
Nearly 81% of drivers admit they use texting while driving, which contributes to the 6,000 deaths that happen a year by distracted drivers.
Once you've seen as realistically as can be portrayed, what it's actually like to be involved in or witness or experience a texting and driving accident, I'm not sure that you get the point as well.
Society for Human Resource Management students gave out pledges on campus to not text and drive, and also gave a real-life demonstration of how dangerous texting and driving really is.
There's an attraction to a device that's that handy that makes it difficult for us to stay focused sometimes on the things that we should stay focused on. And there's probably no time regularly that's more critical that you pay attention than when you're driving a couple tons of steel down the road.
You can take the pledge at any time at donttextdrive.com. Reporting for MEH, I'm Maddie Shine.
Hey, everyone loves IPFW. Okay, maybe you don't. I mean, don't get me wrong, it's all right. But have a look around. Many of us lack school pride about attending IPFW. There's no school spirit, no energetic campus lifestyle, no football games. But while we don't have these things, we do have something else: diversity. 14,000 plus students from over 50 countries. We have fairly cheap tuition and smaller class sizes than the main campuses in Bloomington and Lafayette. Oh yeah, and you get the same degree for a fraction of the cost. Remember this, the whole college experience includes a mountain of debt. Well, unless you're a genius, or you're a tremendous athlete, or you purchase your degree off the internet. IPFW, pragmatism redefined.
Hi, I'm Nick Hymack, here for your inaugural pop culture review. For this segment, I'll be providing you with some reviews on everything recently relevant in pop culture, from video games to television episodes, what to catch on Netflix this week, and the best albums dropping. I'll be telling you what to watch, why to watch it, and what to skip. Because you can't think for yourself, because 2.5 Men has the highest ratings.
No.
Because who has time to catch everything? Yeah. Let's get started. This past week marked the 50th anniversary of the coolest man in cinema, Bond, James Bond. In order to mark the occasion, new clips from Bond's new movie Skyfall were released, along with a new trailer and the film's title song, written and performed by Adele. This new Bond has Javier Bardem, aka the guy from No Country for Old Men, as the main villain, and is directed by the stellar Sam Mendes. Come November 9th, find yourself in the nearest theater. This one should be good. For a film currently in theaters, give Looper a try. Currently sitting at 93% on RottenTomatoes.com, Looper is unlike the by-the-numbers Hollywood thrillers and sci-fi films that pass through theaters each year. The main character, played by Joseph Gordon-Levitt, is hard to like or relate to. Complex themes involving choice, the cost of love, and redemption are all fleshed out so well you will have an emotional response. The plot makes you think, involves time travel and assassins, but most importantly, it treats the audience as, shocker, intelligent. Equal parts intense and original sci-fi, Looper is a dark tale that refuses to compromise storytelling. However, the casual audiences might be best advised checking out Taken 2 instead. In comics, the Avengers vs. X-Men conflict finally wrapped up. Wait, you don't care? Well, even if you're not an avid comic book reader, you should know that, spoiler alert, Professor Xavier of the X-Men died during the Marvel event. Ooh, bet you feel like a jerk now, don't you? Don't you? The fall television seasons are finally back in swing, and fans of Dexter and The Office should rejoice. Both shows are finally back in form. The folks at Dexter have finally upped the ante they've been teasing for 6 seasons now. But the recently struggling Office has been brought out of its own comatose by showrunner Greg Daniels. Listen, this is big because Daniels is the one who originally adapted The Office to the United States and acted as the executive producer for the show's first few years. You remember, back when that was winning Emmys and stealing your awkward heart? Well, he left to go create another great show, Parks and Rec. But for The Office's final season, he's back, and it shows. Check it out. And finally, what to watch this weekend on Netflix? The Walking Dead Season 2. With Halloween and the next season of AMC's drama just around the corner, Season 2 has finally been released for legal streaming online. Catch up on this fantastic series if you're a fan of intense drama, gory mayhem, and storytelling that's anything but dead. I'm Nick Heimek with this episode's Pop Culture Review. Now for some continuity errors. Kylie, back to you.
Thanks, Nick. I think I'll stick with the Big Bang Theory this time.
Oh, come on!
Up next, we had our expert sleuths take to the streets in order to find the best upcoming musical artists at IPFW. Bryce Pratcher is a budding rapper, and our own Andre Satter sat down to discuss his background, music, and potential future as rapper from Fort Wayne, Indiana.
Welcome to the Mastodon Entertainment Hub. I'm Andre Satter. I'm here at IPFW with Bryce. We're going to be talking a little bit about his rap game, how he got into music. So Bryce, tell me, how did this all start?
It all started with me being a young kid. I was always in trouble, and I kind of had to think of a way to get out of trouble, so I'd write poems and sweet letters to my mom, and then it kind of escalated to me writing poems and things like that to women, and that's kind of when I realized I had a kind of a thing for wordplay, and it even went on to me doing it at church all the time, and so I was in choir there as well.
So I've heard you've been called the voice of IPFW. You want to tell me about that?
Yeah, I was called that by some people over on campus, basically due to we have a chancellor who is actually retired. Mm-hmm. And after 18 years of service, they heard about me and some of the music, the things I do musically, and a couple of other artists as well. And they recruited us to basically write this song, and they, you know, put us in a nice studio and purchased us the beat after we found it.
So what does your family think about what you're doing?
Oh, man.
Like when your mom's hears what you're doing, like what does she say?
My mom, probably more hype than I've ever, like, I mean, I'm hyped to make it. I'm excited. But my mom, oh, man, she can't wait. She's so excited to just be at a Grammy show sitting next to me and, you know, seeing me make it. She's ecstatic about the whole thing, loves my music and supports me 100%. Yeah. And so does the rest of my family. They're excited.
Moms like to see their babies succeed.
Oh, yeah, so she just tries her hardest to make sure I never give up, and, you know, she says she supports me whatever happens.
Nice. So was there ever, like, a time when you, like, played around with, like, you know, doing, like, Little Bryce or, like, you know, some funky kind of rap name like that? Or, like, what's some nicknames that you've kind of messed around possibly doing?
That's embarrassing. When I was, like, 12 up to, like, 14, 15, I went by Lil D. Lil D. My real name is Da Bryce, so and I go by Bryce now. But, you know, you had your Lil Bow Wow and Lil Romeo. I was Lil D. And it's all funny because I haven't thought about it until you asked me. So, yeah.
So you're kind of maturing out of that a little bit?
Yeah, I decided, you know, I feel like I'm going to take off, and I don't want the, you know, the cliche name that means nothing to me. Absolutely nothing, you know. It's just not for me.
Like what Shakespeare said, what's in a name?
Yeah, I'd rather just be Bryce.
All right, so you said back in the day, you used to do a little bit of battling, a little bit of freestyle.
Yeah.
Would you mind spitting a couple lines for us real quick?
Okay, cool. Off the top of the head, chilling with Andre. Got them rhymes and them flows that go hard like Kanye. You already know I'm going tight like knee highs. Fresh up in my Vans, New York hat with my Levi's. You can't see me, I'm looking at you, I'm looking past you. Boy, why you talking? Ain't nobody even ask you. At IPF Dub, chilling Fort Wayne. Already know I ain't in it, but I know the game. So, yeah.
Yeah.
So, you know, I just got a couple things for you, but.
I like it.
Yeah,
I like it. All right, you want to give any shout-outs to anybody?
Shout-outs to, first off, God and my family and friends. They're the ones that support me. And shout-out to everybody who still, like me, still wants to make it. I haven't, you know, I'm not anything yet. I'm going to keep working. So I encourage y'all to do the same.
Love it. So, yeah, keep going hard in the paint. Well, dude, thanks a lot. I liked hearing you. This was... Mastodon Entertainment Hub. I'm Andre Satter, here with Bryce at IPFW here in Fort Wayne, Indiana. So, keep it classy.
No. Oh, no. Oh, no.
It doesn't exist.
You don't exist.
Thank you.
Did you just get the chills? I just got the chills.
Yeah, chili's great. Anyway, now it's time for the IPFW love letter. So sit back, relax. We'll handle this. Can we like dim the lights? There we go, that's good. IPFW, I love you, but thanks for putting a yo-yo on the way to the gym. Work out? No, I'll pass.
IPFW, I love you, but why have a Pizza Hut that serves hamburgers? Is pizza too mainstream?
I love you, IPFW, but you're trying to become independent of IU and Purdue. That's nice because we hate receiving degrees from large nationally recognized universities for less money.
I love you, IPFW, but no Macs in the 24-hour computer labs.
IPFW, we love you. And that's it for this episode of MET, your Mastodon Entertainment Hub.
Follow us on Facebook and Twitter for extra episode content and tell us what you think. Seriously, we want your opinions.
And if you want to find yourself on an episode of MET, it's really easy. Just post a video on our wall. From you and your friends singing Call Me Maybe, to complaining about the presidential election, to writing and shooting your own sketches, we want to help air your content to our viewers.
Every single four of them. From your Mastodon Entertainment Hub, I'm Travis Bartlett.
And I'm Kylie Havens. We'll see you next time.
Perfect.
That was good.